Hey, hello and welcome to my lovely students out there. We are with the chapter quadrilaterals and we had discussed about parallelogram, then rhombus, square, rectangle. Today we will be discussing about a new quadrilateral called as trapezium. It's not new. Right from our childhood days we are drawing trapezium. Are you able to recollect? Just recollect it. When I was in my primary class, I used to draw the house this way. Yes, okay. Unknowingly there, I was in touch with this quadrilateral called as trapezium. The upper part of my house, the lower part is ideally a rectangle or it can be a square. But the upper part, no? How the roof of the house used to be this way, right? So this part is nothing but trapezium. What is the trapezium? What is the trapezium? Trapezium is a quadrilateral where one pair of opposite sides are parallel. Okay, for the time being, let me remove this below part of the house. I just need the roof of the house. One pair of opposite sides are parallel, whereas the other pair of opposite sides, the next pair of opposite sides, are they parallel? No, they are intersecting. They will intersect. They are non-parallel. Such a quadrilateral is called as a trapezium. What is a trapezium? A quadrilateral in which only one pair of opposite sides are parallel, whereas the other two sides are intersecting. Sides are parallel, whereas the other two pair, as you can see, they are intersecting. They are non-parallel. Understood the definition of a trapezium? A quadrilateral in which one pair of opposite sides are parallel and the other pair is intersecting is called a trapezium. Now, the quadrilateral where both the opposite pairs are parallel, what is that quadrilateral called as? A quadrilateral in which pair of opposite sides are parallel is called as? Where both the sides are parallel is called as? Yes, parallelogram. Okay, in trapezium, what is the case? Only one pair of opposite sides are parallel, whereas the other is intersecting. Understood what is a trapezium? Now, let us learn about the next type of trapezium. It is called as isosceles trapezium. Isosceles trapezium. Isosceles trapezium, isosceles triangle, you know, where two sides are congruent. In a triangle, when two sides are congruent, it is called as an isosceles triangle. Same way, in an isosceles trapezium, what will happen? These two sides are congruent. Okay? Where non-parallel sides are congruent. These two non-parallel sides are congruent. Such a quadrilateral or such a trapezium is called as an isosceles trapezium. So, I have drawn a quadrilateral. Let me name it as ABCD. Here, as you can see, AB parallel to DC. And if I say that side AD is congruent to side BC. These two non-parallel sides hai and they are congruent. If the non-parallel sides are congruent, then this quadrilateral becomes an isosceles trapezium. So these are the things that you will be showing in your figure. Is it done? Now if you understood what is an isosceles trapezium, what is a trapezium, we can quickly jump into the practice set 5.4. So here we have the first question of practice set 5.4. In quadrilateral IJKL, IJ parallel to KL, only one pair of sides are given parallel. That means you should think about isosceles trapezium. No, you should think about trapezium. If only one side, one pair of opposite sides are given parallel, you will think about trapezium. Okay. So, let us draw IJ parallel to KL. So, this I'll name it as IJ and IJKL. No? So, KL. Clockwise direction. No? So, this is a trapezium. Only one pair of opposite sides are parallel. So, I will make it look like a trapezium. Draw the figure somewhat like this. Okay. So this is looking like a trapezium where IJ parallel to KL. Angle I is given as 108 degree. Angle K is given as 53 degree. Okay. Find the measures of angle J and angle L. Now let us write the given details first. Given quadrilateral IJKL, IJ parallel to KL, angle I 108 degree, angle K 53 degree. To find angle J and angle K. First, everything written, given and to find. Next, we will go for solution. Now, before we go to the solution, let us discuss. IJ is parallel to KL. For two parallel lines and a transversal, now do you remember all the types of angles? Alternate, interior and corresponding. So, here, if IJ is parallel to LK or KL, you can see this type of angle. What is this type of angle which makes C shape called? Yes, interior angles. So, you can see a C here as well as you can see a C here. Okay, interior angle pair this side. So, we know that if IJ is parallel to LK, then angle I plus angle L will be equal to 180 degree. Reason, interior angles. Same way, angle J plus angle K is equal to 180 degree interior angles. Okay, interior angles are supplementary. So, using this property, you can easily get the measures of angle J and angle L. Okay, so let's start. So, I'll start with the solution. Solution. Angle I plus angle L equal to 180. Reason, you have to write. Interior angles, parallel and all we have already written, so no need to write it again. I and L, interior angles. Angle I is 108 plus angle L is equal to 180. Therefore, angle L equal to 180 minus 108. Subtract 10 minus 8, 2. 7 minus 0, 7. And then you have 1 minus 1, 0. Fine. So, angle L you are getting as 72 degree. Angle L you got 72 degree. Same way, find out angle J. Angle J plus angle K. Next step, angle J plus angle K is equal to 180 degree. Same reason you will write. Interior angles. Interior angles. Angle J as it is plus angle K is given as 53. Equal to 180, therefore angle J is equal to 180 minus 53, subtract 10 minus 3, 7, then we have 7 minus 5, 2 and 127. Okay, so angle J we are getting 127 degree. Very easy. Okay, so first sum done. Okay, coming to sum number 2, read the question. In quadrilateral ABCD, side BC parallel to side AD, only one pair of sides are given parallel. So, automatically we will be thinking about trapezium because only in trapezium, one pair of opposite sides are parallel. Side AB congruent to side DC, additional information. Angle A 72, find measure of angle B and angle D. Without the figure, we can't solve this sum. So, first we will write solution. Okay, and let us draw the figure ABCD, BC parallel to AD. So, I will first try to draw BC. Okay, using scale, let us draw BC parallel to AD. No, so how should I write? AD means I can't write here because a quadrilateral should be ABCD. So, I'll write A here, ABCD. Now, only one pair of opposite sides parallel. So, I got a clue that this is a trapezium. So, I'll try to make the other two sides this way. Now, one more additional information. AB is congruent to DC. AB is here congruent to DC. So, if the non-parallel sides are congruent, then this quadrilateral becomes an isosceles trapezium. This is an isosceles trapezium. Angle A is given as 72 degree. Then find measure of angle B and angle D. If you see in the previous sum, we had two measures of angles given and the other two were asked. So easily we could take interior angles, one pair on the left side, one pair on the right side, and we got the answer. But what is the problem here? Only measure of one angle is given and they are asking us to find remaining two, that is angle B and angle D. Angle B and angle D. Angle B we will easily get, no children, because see again, if BC is parallel to AD, you will get the interior angles to be 180 degree. But what about C and D? There is no information about C. So how will we get the angle D? Let us think. First, let us go for angle B. Using the interior angles property, we will find angle B. Come on, start. So given things and all, you will write that I need not say. Write this as given. This as given. Angle A 72 degree. Find measure B and angle D. I'll start with the solution part. So first I'll write side BC parallel to side AD. Angle A equal to 72 degree. Everything is given. I wrote it once again. Therefore, angle B plus angle A is equal to 180 degree. Why? Interior angles. Interior angles. Fine? Now, how much is angle B? We don't know. But do you know angle A? Yes, 72 equal to 180. So therefore, angle B is equal to 180 minus 72, which is equal to 10 minus 2, 8. And you have the answer as 108 degree. So I'll highlight angle B is equal to 108 degree. Okay, so one question's answer we got very easily. Now we want a measure of angle D, but we don't know measure of angle C. So now what to do? Okay, so what to do? Yes, we will have to do a construction. What we will do is, from point B, we will draw a perpendicular. We will draw a perpendicular. Same way from point C also, we will draw a perpendicular. Okay, this part I'll erase now. So the 72 and all also I'll erase. Yeah. So, I drew a perpendicular from B and from C. So, this was A. This is D. Fine? So, this was our figure. This is our figure A, B, C, D. To this, what did I do? I drew a perpendicular from point B and a perpendicular from point C. Now what will happen here? BC is parallel to AD. They are parallel sides. So they are parallel. Between two parallel sides, whatever measure I take, what about those measure? How much, if suppose BC is parallel to AD, it is given BC is parallel to AD. So the distance between two parallel sides, distance between two parallel sides will be equal or what? Correct. No, it will be equal, right? So, if suppose this distance is 3, then this will also be 3. This will also be 3. This will also be 3. Because we know that between two parallel sides, the distance will be the same. Distance will be equal. Correct. So, between the, suppose this part and this part of the board, between two parallel sides, this distance is the same. Correct. So, first perpendicular, let me take it as BM, and this perpendicular I'll take it as CJ. Okay, CJ. So this is our construction. What about BM and CJ? It is the distance between two parallel sides, so it is going to be congruent. Now I will try to prove this triangle BMA congruent to triangle CJD. These two triangles I want to prove them congruent. Just think, how will I prove them congruent? To prove congruent, we need three things. So I'll write. Please, you write construction. Construction. Let us write construction. Draw segment BM and segment CJ. Segment BM and segment CJ perpendicular, perpendicular to side AD, perpendicular to side AD. To side AD, we drew the perpendicular. That is BM, BM, and here CG. Okay. Now we will try to prove these two triangles congruent. How will we try to prove the triangle congruent? Just think and tell me. See, this is perpendicular means 90 degree. Huh? So angle BMA, angle CJD 90 degree. One we got. Second, just now I told distance between two parallel sides means BM congruent to CJ. And one more thing we know that BA is congruent to CD. It is given, it is an isosceles trapezium. So three things we got. So both the triangles are congruent by which test? Is it SAS, SSS, hypotenuse side test? Yes, it is congruent by hypotenuse side test. You can see this is 90 degree and this is the hypotenuse. So both the triangles are congruent by hypotenuse side test. Okay, so I hope you wrote the construction. Now let us start. In triangle BMA and triangle CJD, BMA and CJD, angle BMA congruent to angle CJD, reason both are right angles, right? 90 degree. Perpendicular means 90 degree. Then we know that segment BM congruent to segment CJ. Why? Why BM is congruent to CJ? Because it is coming between two parallel sides. Though parallel sides ke beech ka distance will be the same. Correct, na? So you will write BM is congruent to CJ. Reason, distance between two parallel sides. Fine. And what is the third thing that we have? Side AB congruent to side CD. This is given. So write down, therefore triangle BMA congruent to triangle CJD by hypotenuse side test. Congruent to triangle CJD by hypotenuse side test. Now why did we do this? Why did we prove these two triangles congruent? Just to prove that if BMA is congruent to CJD, then angle B is congruent to angle C, angle M is congruent to angle J, which we already took. Angle A congruent to angle D. Just look at A and D. How much is angle A? Let's check out. Angle A is 72. And we got angle A congruent to angle D. So angle D, which is there in the question, angle D will also be 72. Okay. So CACT we will write. Therefore, angle A congruent to angle D. CACT. Congruent angles of corresponding angles of congruent triangles. Okay. So if A is congruent to D, A is 72. So D will also be 72 degree. And we already got measure of angle B. Isn't it easy now? So if you have only one angle given, then too you can find the remaining angles by taking these two triangles and proving them congruent. I hope you understood it. Coming to the third and the final sum of practice set, the question goes, in quadrilateral ABCD, side BC is greater than side AD. Okay, that we will think about it later. BC parallel to side AD, only one pair of sides are given parallel. So I am drawing a trapezium ABCD. So I'll start from below here, ABCD. Then only I'll get BC parallel to AD. So this way we will draw the figure. Side BA is congruent to side CD. So one pair of parallel, non-parallel sides are congruent. So this is an isosceles trapezium. Then prove that ABC congruent to DCB. So these two angles we want to prove congruent. Okay. So just by the trapezium we will not be able to prove it. We will have to do a construction like we did in the second sum. So same construction we will do. Let us draw perpendicular from B and perpendicular from C. And we know that between two parallel lines, the perpendicular drawn, the distance between two parallel lines is always same. So this perpendicular, here also I'll name it as BM and this be CG. Okay, so that we will write as construction. So first write given quadrilateral ABCD where BC is parallel to AD, BA is congruent to CD, side BA congruent to side CD. Write all that given details. Then to prove, what is to be proved? Angle ABC congruent to angle DCB. This is to be proved. Let's start with proof. Now in proof, please mention the construction. What construction we did? What is the construction that we did? We took draw segment BM and segment CJ. So same construction you have to do. Draw segment BM and segment CJ perpendicular to side AD. Let us start with the proof. That is in triangle BMA and triangle CJD. Like we proved the triangles congruent in the previous sum. Same way you prove the triangles congruent. First thing what you will write? AB congruent to CD. This is given. Then we have BM congruent to side CJ. Why? BM and CJ, it is the distance between two parallel sides. So you will write distance between two parallel sides. Distance between two parallel sides. And last, what you have? Angle, right angle. Angle BMA congruent to angle CJD, both 90 degree or each right angle. Any way you can write. So both the triangles are congruent by, both these two triangles are congruent by which test? Is it SAS, SSS, hypotenuse side test? Okay. So therefore, triangle BMA congruent to triangle CJD by hypotenuse side test. Hypotenuse side test. Why are we taking this? Why are we doing this? Why are we proving the triangles congruent? To take CACT. Now what CACT will you take? Again, same. You will take angle A congruent to angle D. Therefore, angle A congruent to angle D. Reason CACT. CACT. Angle A congruent to angle D. Give this as number 1. Now, as we know, BC parallel to AD. So, therefore, which are the interior angles? Interior angles are, now one letter name you can use. Angle B plus angle A equal to 180. Correct? Interior angle same way. Angle C plus angle D is equal to 180. So, both the pair of interior angles I took. So, one reason I'll write interior angles. Interior angles. Now, here this I will give it as number 2. As you can see for number 2, both right hand side 180, 180. If right hand side is same, the left hand side will also be same. So, from 2 I can write, therefore, angle B plus angle A is equal to angle C plus angle D. Now, RHS 180, so left hand side is also equal. So here I'll write from 2. Now observe closely what you want. You want angle B congruent to angle C. So B is here, C is here. Somehow we want to cancel this A and D. Look up. Just few minutes before we said in CACT that angle A congruent to angle D. Correct? So, in place of angle A, I can write angle D. Therefore, angle B plus, in place of angle A, I'll write angle D is equal to angle C plus angle D. So, angle D on left side, angle D on right side will get cancelled. Here you will write from 1. So as you want, you got angle B congruent to angle C. That is what we want. You can write in 3-letter name. Okay. So by using 1-letter name, it is easy to write and confusion is also less. So here we got angle B congruent to angle C. Hence proved. Fine. So how did we solve this? By constructing perpendicular, taking the triangle and coming to the thing what we want. So keeping what to be proved in front of our eyes, we got the proof easily. So practice these three sums well. One sum out of this will surely come for your exam. I hope you understood the sums. Meet you with the next part of the chapter in the next class. Bye.